Hello students, in this session we will be learning how to graph linear equation. Now before we get into the lesson, we do a quick recap of what a coordinate plane is, what are the axis, origin, quadrants and how to plot points. The vertical line which is drawn here is known as the y-axis and the horizontal line is known as the x-axis. Now the two axes are perpendicular to each other. Perpendicular to each other means they intersect each other at 90 degree. Okay, so the vertical is y, the horizontal is x-axis. Both intersect each other at 90 degree. This point of intersection is denoted by the letter O. O stands for origin. So the vertical is y-axis, horizontal is x-axis. The point where the two axes meet is known as origin. Now because of the two axes, the whole plane is divided into four parts. Each part is known as a quadrant. Each part is known as a quadrant. Now going anticlockwise, this one is known as the first quadrant. Then second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Okay. Now, on the right of the y-axis, the right side of the y-axis, all the x-coordinates are positive. The x-coordinates are positive. So, when you go right, it is positive. So, when you go left, it is negative. Similarly, above x-axis, the y-coordinates are positive, so going up is positive and going down will be negative. So, if you plot any point in this coordinate, okay, now every point in the coordinate plane has two coordinates. Those are the x and the y-coordinate. The first coordinate is always the x-coordinate. The second coordinate is the y coordinate. It is an ordered pair. It is a ordered pair. The first one is always x, the second one is always y. In the first quadrant, the x axis is positive, the y is positive, both side it is positive. So every point in the first quadrant, okay, will have both the coordinates positive. Let's look at the second quadrant. The x coordinate are negative, the y coordinates are positive. So the points in the second quadrant will have x negative and y positive. Similarly, in the third one, x is negative, y is also negative. So all the points in the third quadrant will have both x and y negative. And in the fourth quadrant, x coordinates are positive and the y is negative. So every point in the fourth quadrant, x is positive and y is negative. So, just by looking at the sign, we can identify the point will be in which quadrant. So, let's look at some example of plotting points. Now, point A is given to you 4, 3. As we learnt here that the first number 4 is my x coordinate, the second one is my y coordinate. Now, how to locate point A? You always start from the origin. Now this is my origin here where the two axes meet. Point A, x coordinate is +4. So +4. So you will go 4 step to the right. You reach here. Then y coordinate is +3. So you go 3 step up. So you start from the origin, go 4 right and 3 up. You reach at this point. This point is my point A, 4, 3. So if from point A, when you go to the x, you will get x coordinate 4. When you go to the y axis, you will get 3, which is the y coordinate. Let's do one more. Point B is 2, 5. Now, start from the origin. X coordinate is 2. I'm doing point B. X coordinate is 2. So, go to 2. Y coordinate is +5. So, you go up to 5 and stop. So, this is my point B, 2, 5. Point C is -2, 3. Start from the origin. Now, since x is negative, you need to move left. So, go towards minus 2. Now, you reach here. Y coordinate is 3. So, you move 3 steps up because it is positive. So, you reach here. This is your point C, minus 2, comma 3. Let's look at point D. Minus 4, minus 3. Now, point D, start from the origin. X is negative. So, you cannot go right. You need to go left. You reach to minus 4. Then y coordinate is minus 3, so you cannot go up, you need to go down till minus 3. So, this is my point D, minus 4, minus 3. To double check, from point D, when you go to x, you should get minus 4, when you go to y, you should get minus 3. Now, the next one, point E, 4, comma 0. So, x coordinate is 4, start from the origin, go to x coordinate 4, you reach here. Now, the y coordinate is 0. So, can we go up? You will say no. Can we go down? No. So, it means you cannot move from here. So, this is my point E, 4, comma 0. Let's look at point F, minus 3, comma 0. Start from the origin, go to minus 3. So, you reach here. Y coordinate is 0. So, you cannot move up, you cannot move down. So, you stay at the same place. So, this is my point F. Minus 3, comma 0. Now, you see something similar in these two points. If you look carefully, the y coordinate is 0 for both the points. And look at the position of the two points on the coordinate plane. Both the points are on the x-axis. So, what we conclude here is, if the y coordinate is 0, the points will be on x-axis. So, points are on x axis. So, you can guess now what will happen with the next two points. Now, point G is 0, 4. Start from the origin. Again, start from the origin. X coordinate is 0. So, you cannot go right, you cannot go left. So, you stay in the same place. Y coordinate is 4. So, you move up to 4. So, you reach here. So, this point is my point G, 0, 4. Let's come to point H, 0, minus 3. X coordinate is 0, so you cannot go right and left. Y is minus 3, so come down to minus 3. So, this is my point H, 0, comma, minus 3. Now, again, look at these two points. Here, in these two, the X coordinate is 0. And if you look at the position of the points, they are on the Y axis. So, the points lie on Y axis. So, this is how you plot your points in the coordinate plane. Okay, see you.